How's it going, Dopamon fans? On April 10th, 2022, an altercation took place between Pittsburgh Penguins alternate captain Evgeni Malkin and Nashville Predators defenseman Mark Borowiecki, starting with Boro giving Malkin a late check before Malkin gives him a slash to the abdomen, followed by a crosscheck to the teeth. Borowiecki was bloodied on the play and did not return, and received a minor for slashing, while Malkin received a double minor for high-sticking, not cross-checking. I've got the best angle to break down exactly what happened here, and I want to hear from you guys if you think Malkin should receive supplemental discipline or not. The first angle here is my favorite, as it does show everything. It does the best at summarizing exactly what happened overall. Boro gives Malkin a late check, probably deserves maybe a penalty for that. We see Malkin give him a slash, probably deserves a minor for that as well. And then Boro, when he attempts to shove Malkin back, Malkin cross-checks him in the teeth. This second angle I don't like as much, as it sort of looks like Boro had put Malkin in a kind of headlock that Malkin was maybe retaliating to. But when we go back to the first angle, we do see that Boro barely touches Malkin's head, and rather kind of gives a sort of tug on his arm. Personally, I agree that until the cross-check to the face, that both deserved minor penalties. But let's turn to the NHL rules, so I can break down how the referees made the wrong call. Now, under Rule 60, a high stick is one which is carried above the height of the opponent's shoulders. And under Rule 60.3, the double minor which was called, is if the high stick makes contact with the opponent's neck, face, or head so that injury results in the manner of drawing blood or otherwise. While this is technically correct, let's turn to Rule 59 for cross-checking. Under Rule 59, a cross-check is the action of using the shaft of the stick between the two hands to forcefully check an opponent. Between the two hands is incredibly important because as we swap back to when Malkin makes contact, we clearly see the shaft of the stick between his two hands when it hits Borowiecki's face. But I'm not done here. Under Rule 60.3, the double minor for high sticking that was called, there's this extra stipulation. Referees making this call shall have the option, but not the obligation, to review video of the play for the purpose of confirming, or not, their original call on the ice. This means the refs were absolutely capable of reviewing video of Malkin making contact with Boro's face to make the right call, but chose not to. We all know right now there's a huge discussion about the inconsistencies in the way that officials are calling games, and this does not help give them any defense to see that they had the option to make the right call on the ice and decide not to. Now, Malkin is not a repeat offender by the NHL's definition, but he does have a disciplinary history and hasn't been one to shy away from some of the rough stuff. In February of 2019, he was suspended one game for swinging his stick high at Michael Raffel, and his only fine was a fight with JG Pageau, barely worth noting. I don't think that fine is going to come into play here, but he has been suspended once in the past. But to the incident at hand, the best, most recent comparison I can make is to this cross-check to the head by Austin Matthews on Rasmus Dahlin, for which he was suspended two games. In both cases, the target of the cross-check was guilty of making the initial check before receiving a check to the head or face. Now, some differences. Matthews obviously lunged with significantly more force compared to Malkin, but Rasmus Dahlin was not injured, while Borowiecki lost what few teeth he has left and didn't return to the game. Boro is not one to act injured. He is a tough guy. He's a strong guy. He's known for his toughness. So I think it's a pretty big deal that he sat out. Personally, I'd be calling for the same two-game suspension that Matthews got, but at least somewhere in the 1-3 game range. And that's all for this one. Let me know down below how many games you think Malkin should be suspended for, if at all. And I want to hear your thoughts about officiating in the NHL right now. Of course, there's a huge discussion about it. I don't think the right call was made here. Of course, Boro was given a slashing call. I'd love for somebody to explain where anywhere here Boro gets a slash. Until next time, don't forget to hit like and subscribe. We're Dopamon. My best friend and I talk hockey news, analysis, and we have a lot prepared for the draft. So stick around. Peace.